It's summertime, and Major League Lacrosse is in full swing. Just about every weekend from May to August, the best players in the world travel from city to city, suiting up for their respective teams. Lacrosse is the fastest game on 2 feet, and it's gaining popularity just as fast. But it still has a ways to go before rivaling some of the more traditional pro sports. For these players, it's not about the money or the fame. It's simply for the love of the game, getting a chance to play it in its purest form. It takes a certain type of athlete to succeed at this level. The MLL summer is an absolute grind. Many have other commitments Monday through Friday, but they still find time to train and compete come Saturday. One of the best parts about this league is getting to meet the unique and colorful characters that play this sport, searching for purity every weekend during the MLL summer. Our story begins in Atlanta, Georgia, following two Long Island natives, Matt Gibson and Tom Palasek. It's the day before game day, and after a full, luxurious night's sleep, Gibby's pretty eager to get on the road.
Pally, we gotta go.
Morning, Tom. It's always a challenge staying on schedule when traveling with Tom.
Get that moving, too.
All right, man. Chill, jeez.
Dude, made it very evident to you what the plan was this morning.
Neither of these guys actually live here.
No, like 8 o'clock.
This is teammate Scott Ratliff's house. This is Matt's house. Matt agreed to give us a tour of his home. Thank you, Matt. Here we have the living room. Master bedroom. I believe that's an antique nightstand. Some mementos and some wall decor. The boys decided they were going to drive Gibby's house to their game this weekend.
Yeah, this is going to be a great trip though, in the van.
That is if Pally would ever finish packing.
I wish he had like a couple days.
Pally, time to go!
We're not sure if Tom had all his pads, but Gibby runs a tight ship and they're on a schedule. Here's Gibby teaching Tom a much-needed lesson on punctuality. And just like that, the boys are off. You never really know where the MLL summer is going to take you. It just so happens that the Atlanta Blaze are playing in Charleston, South Carolina this weekend. A short 4-hour drive from Atlanta. On second thought, make that 6 hours. The boys are in a 2005 Ford E350. We're not exactly winning any races here.
It's filling up, right?
Whatever you say, Gibby.
I got peach rings, I got gummy bears, I got
As Gibby and Tom finally make some progress, let's take a trip up the coast to Boston, home of the 2018 MLL All-Stars. Enter Scott Ratliff, Connor Busick, Kevin Rice. You play really well all summer, you get elected to the All-Star team. Here's Kevin right now, being an All-Star. Some of the All-Stars are a little frustrated they didn't make Team USA. Here's Scott taking out his frustration on some Team USA guys. Scott's a long pole, but don't turn your head on him. Because we'll do something like this. At least he's pretty modest about it. Connor shoots really hard. And by hard, we mean 112 miles an hour. It's pretty hard. Kevin's pretty comfortable from this spot. Nothing to see here, really. Just a routine low and away from Kevin. When you need a game-tying goal, you can usually trust Connor to put the biscuit in the basket. Here's Will Manny sneaking one by some Team USA guy, giving the MLL All-Stars a W.
It's always a great honor to play on the field with the best in the world. You know, that's a fantastic squad. I think we had a great group of guys in blue tonight. And you know, to play it at that caliber and with those type of caliber players, it's an honor. It's a lot of fun out there.
Back down south, the boys were running behind schedule. Tom seemed pretty bent out of shape that he might miss practice. When your van tops out at 50 miles per hour, you have to pull over from time to time and let some traffic pass by. The battery also died on us. Luckily, Gibby fancies himself a mechanic. Here he's doing his signature move of jiggling the wire. I don't know who taught him that one, but it seemed to work. At this rate, they figured they were going to miss practice anyway, so why not stop and get some tattoos? They had a hunch this place could help them. The whole process was pretty quick and painful. Nonetheless, spirits were high. Pally says, "Hey, that's pretty sweet. You got an upside-down chair." Gibby says, "It's not upside down to me." Pally got a pretty sweet line. Anybody tell him that's permanent? It's just cornfields from here on out, so we figured this was a good time to take a break for a message from our corporate sponsor.
My boss is StringKing. Kind of a stiff. You know what's even stiffer? The Mark II V head. Minimizing flex on the scoop, giving players greater accuracy. Starting to sound like him.
After an 8-hour trip, they made it to Charleston with 5 minutes to spare. Tyler was so excited, he high-fived the camera crew. The MLL summer is like a mini reunion each weekend. Scott flew in from Boston. There's Matt McCready's flying in from Philly. Smile for the camera, Kevin. At the start of practice, the weather was 92 degrees, humidity 66%. You're sweating before you even put the pads on. Gibby was placed on IR this week. If it was up to him, he probably would have given it a go. With Friday practice in the books, it's a short walkthrough Saturday morning and game time's here before you know it. Some guys miss Friday practice, but wouldn't miss game day for anything. Here's netminder Adam Gittleman. Midfielder Justin Pennington. Got a good stretch there, Justin. And Australian defenseman Callum Robinson. As Tom gets one last practice shot in, and Callum visualizes breaking someone's arm, it's game time. Kevin gets the blaze started with some high heat. He told you he was comfortable from that spot. Ball movement's pretty important in the MLL. Watch here as the ball moves through X, thanks to the backside. A nice, easy top right rip. Give us a little dance, Pally. There we go. Callum thought not once, but twice about shooting. Figured he'd better not. Maybe just do that whole ball movement thing. Wing play can be pretty intense in the MLL. Just when you think you missed your opportunity, the ball ends up bouncing back your way. And then Callum joins the party and says, "This one's mine." Shot clock winds down, sometimes you have to get unconventional. Here's Cuccinello going airborne. Here's Palasek about to dodge to his left. I could have sworn he was going left. Palasek stuck this one right before halftime, giving the Blaze a lead going into the locker room. Heavies left the field. The young guns thought, hey, we can do that. Look at this, fourth grade in a non-traditional hotbed, and they're already running textbook fast breaks. He's wide open on the crease, a little high to low. Not much of a celly there. Tom came back on the field and said, hey, great job, everybody. Now scram. Here's Kevin taking off on one of his signature long dives. Kevin likes to wear his defender out. He doesn't see the slide coming. He'll just put his shoulder down and take whatever angle he's got. There's a flag on the play. I think it was on Callum. He doesn't seem to agree with the call. Here's Kevin, taking off on one of his signature long dodges. Wait, did I already say that? When you drive to the middle of the field, there's a good chance you're going to get hit. Here's Pally, in the middle of the field, getting hit. He seemed to shake it off pretty quickly. Kevin's already had enough goals tonight, so he says, hey, Rook, you take this one. With a convincing score of 16-10, Scott, Kevin, and Tom are feeling pretty good about themselves. Most of these players, there will be a modest celebration tonight, early flights home tomorrow, and then they'll be counting down the days until they can do it all again next weekend, chasing the MLL summer.